The U.S. Navy's fiscal year 2026 shipbuilding plan calls for the procurement of 6 new vessels, including 2 Virginia-class nuclear-powered fast attack submarines. These submarines, anticipated to be named USS Potomac and USS Norfolk, will initiate production of Block 6. Their delivery is projected for the mid-2030s. While the hull numbers have not been officially assigned in the fiscal year 2026 budget, SSN-814 and SSN-815 are the most likely designations, following the April 2025 award of SSN-813, named USS Atlanta. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes what more Block 6 Virginia class brings to the table compared to Block 5. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. One of the key enhancements in Block 6 is the continued incorporation of the Virginia payload module. An 84-foot mid-body section equipped with 4 vertical launch tubes, each capable of carrying 7 Tomahawk missiles. In addition to carrying Tomahawks, Block 6 will be the first Virginia-class variant specifically designed to support the conventional prompt strike program. Rear Admiral David Goggins has confirmed that Block 6 submarines will be equipped with this capability, establishing them as next-generation high-speed strike platforms within the Navy's evolving global force structure. Conventional prompt strike, CPS, is an intermediate-range boost-glide hypersonic weapon system. The CPS all-up-round missile includes a 2-stage solid rocket motor booster and a common hypersonic glide body, CHGB, containing a kinetic energy projectile warhead. The glider will be launched to extremely high altitude, then separate from the carrier missile, and will skim back to the Earth towards its intended target, attaining hypersonic speed. Block 6 will also introduce built-in seabed warfare capabilities. The design features upgraded sonar for precise close-in navigation and mapping, optimized towed array configurations for better detection of seabed installations, and new deployment systems for underwater sensors and effectors. Block 6 submarines will also feature enhanced launch and recovery systems for unmanned platforms, enabling them to deploy advanced systems such as Raytheon's Barracuda drone, designed for mine detection and clearance. These upgrades reflect a broader shift in U.S. naval doctrine that recognizes the seabed as a contested battle space, one that demands continuous presence, situational awareness, and operational control during conflict. This upgrade comes amid a rise in incidents involving damage to underwater energy infrastructure and data cables in the Baltic Sea, prompting NATO to ramp up efforts to counter suspected acts of sabotage. Viewers may note that on January 14, 2025, while announcing a new NATO mission, dubbed Baltic Sentry, to safeguard the underwater infrastructure critical to the economic stability of Baltic region nations, Secretary General Mark Rutte stated, "We will do everything in our power to fight back, to detect what is happening, and to take the necessary steps to ensure it doesn't happen again. And our adversaries should know this." In this context, it is important to note that power and communications cables, along with gas pipelines, interconnect the 9 countries bordering the Baltic Sea, which is a relatively shallow and nearly landlocked body of water. While continuing to use pump jet propulsion and earlier acoustic dampening measures, these submarines are expected to incorporate improved hull coatings and advanced machinery isolation systems to further reduce detectability during deep-sea missions and operations near the seabed. Internally, equipment layout and system integration will be optimized to enable quieter performance, even during high-speed or high-agility maneuvers. This will increase the gap vis-a-vis rivals. Current Virginias have a sound level of 95 decibels. In comparison, Type 093 Shang-class nuclear attack submarine of People Liberation Army Navy has a sound level of 110 decibels. Importantly, Type 094 Gen class nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines, which Virginians are supposed to stalk, have a sound level of 120 decibels. While Chinese have still some way to go, Russia has made considerable progress. The Yasin M-class nuclear-powered attack submarine and Borei series of nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines are much quieter than previous classes, and some reports suggest they are at par with initial blocks of Virginia-class subs. Block 6 Virginias will restore the edge. In the digital age, the character of warfare has undergone a profound transformation. One of the most significant developments in this realm is the concept of network-centric warfare, NCW. This doctrine centers on leveraging information superiority, advanced communications, and network systems to enhance situational awareness, decision-making, and combat effectiveness across all domains, land, air, sea, space, and cyberspace. At its core, NCW is based on the premise that a robustly networked force improves information sharing, which in turn enhances the quality of shared situational awareness. This enables faster and more informed decisions, leading to increased mission effectiveness. It represents a shift from platform-centric to information-centric operations, where the focus is on integrating sensors, shooters, and decision makers across a dynamic and resilient digital infrastructure. The key components of network-centric operations include sensors for real-time data collection, networks to transmit and fuse information, and effectors, such as missiles, aircraft, or cyber tools, to execute precise actions. These components need to be linked through a secure, high-bandwidth communications architecture that allows seamless data flow across all command levels and units. One of the most transformative upgrades in Block 6 is the integration of undersea fiber optic networking systems, enabling the submarine to maintain high-bandwidth data links with unmanned vehicles, seabed sensors, and potentially other submarines within the battle space. This capability will facilitate real-time targeting and sensor fusion, allowing the submarine to function as a central node in distributed maritime operations. By moving beyond the constraints of traditional burst transmissions, this advancement allows undersea platforms to contribute continuously to a broader kill web that spans air, sea, land, and cyber domains.